Hey everybody, welcome back to the Daily Mat. Okay, today we had a question come in since we're talking about saws, and this question came in from John Leonick, and John was asking, I have a straight-handled Gent saw I picked up from Lee Valley. Have you had experience with this type of handle, and would you recommend the pistol grip type instead? Regards, John. Well, you know, John, I really haven't had that much experience with the Gent-styled saw. Early on, one of the first saws I bought was this particular one from Lee Valley also, and this goes along with their dovetailing jig. You know, it's a neat little jig that we're going to have to break out that kind of helps to give you an idea of how to cut dovetails if you're really not comfortable doing it by hand. Unfortunately, it's not a traditional back saw in the sense that, I mean, it's very, very flexible. But, you know, a lot of other Japanese saws are similar in nature. Of course, I can never keep them straight. There's like the Ryobi, the Dazuki, there's one or two other ones, but they do have a slight back on them that gives it some more rigidity. But my experience with the Gent style saw is that it is very similar in the sense that when you're holding the handle, again, you don't want a death grip. You don't want to be white knuckling it. See how, I don't know if you can see it really well, my fingernails are starting to turn kind of whitish. And when you put too much of a death grip on any saw, what ends up happening is you lose control. You think you're gaining control, but in fact, you're actually losing control, because then you have a little twitch in your muscle will be translated through the saw itself. So again, even with a Gent style saw, you want to have a just loose, kind of comfortable feel to it. Now, with this particular model, they actually have on both sides, really, when it comes down to it, kind of this little finger hold in here. At least that's what I use it for. And again, I want to have a finger that's going to kind of be pointing the way. So when I'm holding it, again, kind of a loose grip, I like to have my thumb here on top, because what it actually does is it helps to give downward pressure as I'm cutting, so that I can keep, you know, the momentum going as the cut is being made. And again, the finger is out front there. And even with this particular style, again, I'd be using my thumb to help guide the cut, keeping it out of the way of the teeth, of course. So then I would just come down here, and since this is kind of a Japanese style, you would use it on the pull stroke versus on the push stroke. So we'll get it started. Oops. And occasionally it jumps out of the curve, but that's because this blade is actually starting to get very dull. But as we can see, again, you want your body open so that you can take advantage of the full stroke. And that's how you would get a decent cut. Now there, I actually felt myself starting to grab a little too much and try to bully the cut itself. And as I'm looking at this, I can see that it's starting to kind of curve in that direction. Now, this of course is a coping saw, which obviously has kind of that Gent style handle. And for those of you who don't know, a Gent style refers to this particular type of handle here. It's one that just goes straight out. It's not a pistol grip. This, as I mentioned before, is a pistol grip. And I really like this because I feel like I have more control. And it also has to do with the way that my hand is in the position. This is way more natural for sawing than this feels to me, because this really kind of, I really feel like I'm just, the only way to describe it is I feel like I'm not holding it the right way. So I do have to kind of grab it to really, you know, get some more control in it. But again, even with a coping saw, I want that finger pointing the direction. I like to have the thumb up on top, again, pushing down. And you'll notice occasionally my finger will kind of, well, you can't really see it very well, my finger might roll underneath a little bit, but it's still kind of pointing the direction, and it keeps on going. Now, if you've had more experience with the Gent style or the Japanese style, because the majority of the Japanese style saws do have kind of this longer handle that's like that, please let me know what your experiences with it. How do you hold it? I mean, this is, like I said, I don't have that much experience with it, but I found that this works for me and it seems to give me a decent amount of control. So I'm just curious to see what you think about it, and maybe if you have a little advice for John. So I think that's pretty much going to do it for today. If you have a question, of course, you know how to get a hold of me. Stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com, or you can get a hold of me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. So I'll be talking to all of you later. Straight grains and sharp blades.